Dutch Sinse here. 8:16 p.m. Central Time on Monday, October 14th, 2013. And we're looking at Earthquake 3D here, which is a USGS feed of the most recent earthquakes. You can see it, a 7.3 magnitude earthquake struck in the Philippines. And it was relatively shallow. It could be much deeper and it wouldn't cause as much damage, but 35 miles deep, and it's very sizable for the region. No tsunami warning issued, luckily. That's good news. But again, like I said, very sizable for the region, and subsequent aftershocks since the 7.3, a 5.3, and a 5.4. Now, I just want to give you guys a quick rundown over what's occurred over the last several days. Let's first take this down over the last 24 hours. Okay, we're looking at everything 4.0 and greater internationally and 2.5 and greater in the United States. And we had that swarm happening here at the Salton Sea Volcano earlier today, which I did a blog post on. I'll put a link down below to that. We won't waste time looking at that now. But here in the West Pacific, you can see the cluster point. The area where we were seeing previous activity over the last 24 hours has now had the large earthquake movement. Now, to see that cluster, let's go back another 24 and go to 48 hours. Okay? And you can see it again. Here it is. The area in question is the area experiencing the large movement preceded by 4 and 5.0 flurry activity in this general region all around the entire edge of the plate. And that's just the last 48 hours. Now, these are raised up off the planet. That indicates the depth into the Earth. And the higher they are, the deeper they are. You can turn that on or off on Earthquake 3D. This is the full version. But you can see the depths. And the area that moved heavy was surrounded by deeper earthquakes. And we see this time and time again. We'll see deeper earthquakes occur first, and then flurry activity, then large earthquake activity. And I've been putting posts out on my dutchsinse Facebook page. I urge you guys to come over here, and you don't have to like it up, but just at least bookmark it. You don't have to be a Facebook member. You can come over and check, and I do as many updates as I can on here throughout the day. Getting the chance to make a video, process it, upload it to YouTube, manage it, becomes a little bit of a problem. So it's much easier to post it over on Facebook whenever we have an earthquake. I would urge you guys to have an earthquake plan ready and be prepared no matter where you live. Every area on the entire planet can have an earthquake. There are certain areas that are seismically prone. And you can just see the area here, for instance. Whereas if you lived in Asia over the last week, maybe preparing for a large earthquake would have been in order if you knew what was going on. A lot of times they don't tell you. They're not going to tell you to prepare because of this flurry activity. It's kind of a fringe science still. People are still trying to figure out how to predict earthquakes. And I would say that you can look in areas that are already experiencing large amount of 4 and 5.0 earthquakes and expect that large movement to occur there. Now, since we've seen the 7.3 here, we can expect to the east, to the north, and to the west in the near adjacent areas to experience subsequent movement. So across through Alaska, the Aleutian Island chains, going east all the way here to north of New Zealand, and going west through Sumatra, maybe even as far west as this cluster point that's occurring here in India, at the border of India, I think, in Pakistan. We also had a 6.4 strike southern Greece. So we don't normally see anything over 5.0 happening there. They do have 6.0s, even larger, but we haven't seen one there in a fairly long while. And you can just see, you can connect the dots over to the Pacific where this entire area of unrest is occurring. Now, the United States, let's just get quickly in the United States. It's going to take a while to get into this, but when you see the United States activity, let me turn these down, you can see that, again, the edge of the craton is highlighted. The craton is the unsubducted portion of the North American plate. It forms a giant U shape that starts up here in the Pacific Northwest, curls down here to the south through Oklahoma, and then goes back up here to the northeast, pretty much to the split in the continent here. And you can see 2.6 struck up here, I think, in as that New Hampshire. And then we have multiple 3 and 2.0 earthquakes striking at the fracking operation throughout Oklahoma. And then again, up here near Yellowstone, south of Yellowstone, at the area that we don't normally see too much activity, where we saw the 5.0 happen 2 weeks ago, well, that area is starting to move again. And that's the edge of the craton. Now let me turn these back up here. And you can see the 4.5 that occurred off the east coast. Now these are methane hydrate deposits here. They call it the Bermuda Triangle, but really there's a lot of methane activity that's happening in the ocean. We're talking large areas of bubbling methane that can explode, sink ships, and this is the deformed edge of the craton, you can see it highlighted here on the map, that extends out in the coastal plain out to the sea floor. And that's the area that saw the 4.5. So that's kind of odd to see, but when you saw the other activity that occurred at Puerto Rico, okay, and that's just to the southeast here, the stack of earthquakes happening at multiple depths all in the same area, followed by a 6.2 in Venezuela, right off the shores of Venezuela. Again, an area we don't normally see large earthquake activity. There were the 7.0s that happened in Colombia, 6 months ago now, and we haven't seen any follow-up activity there. So that is follow-up activity that we would expect to see in near term, but it took months for this to happen. And I think that's because the transfer that's been occurring, this pressure transfer, is coming from the west, not from the east, not from the Mid-Atlantic Ridge like we would normally think, but it's actually the subduction that's not able to keep up with the Pacific movement to the west. It's a radical theory. I haven't heard it proposed anywhere, but I think that's what's happening, okay? Now, one last thing, guys. I've got a list of links you can go over. We don't have time to go into that now, but I would urge you guys to come over and check all of these. We've got U.S. links, we've got Yellowstone, we've got international links. You can go down the list here. I've got Europe, Oceania, Latin America, as many as I could find it, and I'm trying to update this as much as possible. Another thing you could check are the volcano webcams. Assembled as many volcano webcams as I could find, took the Big Think article and matched it up with any other webcams we could find, and it's always good to go check these and see what's going on. They can sometimes indicate an area to watch for earthquake activity if you watch the volcanic activity as well. A lot of this activity surrounds volcanic areas. Kuril Islands up here in Russia. Okay, south near Japan. Going south through Sumatra. A lot of these are undersea volcanoes that are having the 4 and 5.0 earthquake activity out to sea. And relatively shallow. Much love, folks. Hang in there.